Well, then give me this. It's fine. Yeah. Good morning. So did you like the wind yesterday? You know, it's so interesting because when you watch the wind, it moves things around. And what you thought was in its proper spot, all of a sudden gets moved. And as we were taking a walk yesterday with one of our grand dogs, Brenda and I walked around a corner. And this is one of those things where I didn't do this, and I give credit to my wife, Brenda, for opening my eyes. So we went around a corner, and there was this huge limb that had fallen right in the middle of a sidewalk. So naturally, what do? We just walk over it, because we're not going to do anything with it. It's two blocks away. So I'll give the whole story. So we ended up walking the dog down half the block, and all of a sudden he had to do his job, and we noticed we didn't have any bags. Oh. So I stayed with the dog with the pile, marking it, making sure nobody knew that we were just walking away, and Brenda went back to her house and got, you know, the needed things for that. But on her way back, she noticed that the lady that lived at the corner with the big limb in the sidewalk came out, and she was using a walker. And this limb was big. I mean, it was like from here to halfway down the aisle. So we did our walk, came back, and she said, Dan, we should really just do something with that limb because she's not going to be able to move it. She can't do anything with it. So I dragged it for two blocks and brought it to my garage, and I cut it up. But I thought, you know, sometimes the wind creates things that you don't know that you're going to see. And it gives you opportunities to find something new. We just heard that song, North, South, East, West. And it tells us that there's things that are happening all around us in every direction. God is with us. God is with you. God is with all of us. And this morning, as we explore again the numbers, today is number 4. If you've been following along, unfortunately, all these numbers have been even, right? 10, 8, 4. But it's going to be fun because I want you to think of those things in your life that are 4. Everything from a chair that you sit on to the cross that's behind me. 4 points. So with that, I'm going to invite my confirmation friends to come forward, because they are going to help us with the call to worship, and they're also going to be helping with our prayers this morning. And while they're coming up, I also want to thank the Ransom family, and Nicholas is going to be joining us this morning in baptism as well. So come on up. You can go up to that. So you all remember being in confirmation class, right? There's certain times where you get put on the spot, so this is one of those times. So you can use that microphone, and please join with us in the call to worship. Yep, just walk right up to there. The first
one? Don't be shy.
See, this is fun. Okay, we're going to go like this. Come right up there. Should be there. Yep, here we go.
Let's thank the Lord, for the Lord is good.
God's love endures forever.
Who can proclaim the mighty acts of the Lord or fully declare God's praise?
Blessed are those who act justly, who always do what is right. Our God is worthy of our praise.
Remember us, O Lord, when you show favor to your people, that we may enjoy your blessings.
Let us worship our good God, who blesses us with infinite love and abundant grace. Amen. Lord Jesus, we gather to worship you today with hearts full of joy and appreciation for the beauty of your diversity and extravagant welcome. We invite your Holy Spirit to this space to celebrate your goodness and presence in our gathering time together. Prepare our hearts to receive what you have for us today. Let the people say amen. 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 Thank you. That wasn't so bad, was it?
Our reading today is from Psalm 135, 1 through 4, and 13 through 21. Hallelujah! Praise the name of God. Praise the works of God. All you priests on duty in God's temple, serving the sacred halls of our God, shout hallelujah! Because God is so good, sings anthems to his beautiful name. And why? Because God chose Jacob, embraced Israel as a prized possession. God, your name is eternal. God, you'll never be out of date. God stands up for his people. God holds the hands of his people. The gods of the godless nations are mere trinkets made for quick sale in the markets. Chiseled mouths that can't talk, painted eyes that can't see, carved ears that can't hear, dead wood, cold metal. Those who make and trust them become like them. Family of Israel, bless God. Family of Aaron, bless God. Family of Levi, bless God. You who fear God, bless God. O blessed be God of Zion, first citizen of Jerusalem. Alleluia.
Please stand if you can and join us in our opening hymn, Jesus, Name Above All Names.
Please join with me in our morning prayer. We ask your forgiveness, O Lord, for not being truthful in acknowledging that we have failed you and those you entrusted in our care. We know that we have a long way to go, O Lord. We ask that you open our hearts to be receptive to your Holy Spirit. We ask you to transform our hearts within so that we will be renewed in our commitment to be the beloved community you are calling us to be. God demonstrated his love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Beloved in Jesus Christ, our sins are forgiven. Let the people say amen. 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 Now please take a moment to welcome each other to worship this morning. Good morning. 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 Good morning. Good morning. You may be seated. You guys are so obedient. You're like, I'll just keep standing. It's like really, it's very nice.
Our next reading is Philippians chapter 4, verses 1 through 9. Therefore, my brothers and sisters, you whom I love and long for, my joy and crown, stand firm in the Lord. In this way, dear friends, I plead with Eudaia and plead with, Syntyche, to be the same mind in the Lord. Yes, I ask you, my true companion, help these women since they have contended at my side in the cause of gospel, along with Clement and the rest of my co-workers, whose names are in the book of life. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received, you heard or heard from me or seen in me, put it into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. Here ends our reading.
Well, I invite the family and sponsors for Nicholas. Good morning. I like your suit. Hi, Madison. Good morning. Well, good morning. You didn't have to read anything, so don't worry. Not like confirmation students, but we are so happy that you are here. This is such a glorious day. Thank you for bringing Nicholas and Madison and yourselves this morning. So we'll be following along in the bulletin that you received. So sisters and brothers in Christ, through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We are incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given now birth through water and the Spirit, all that is God's gift, offered to us without price. Even as Jesus welcomed children into his community, we celebrate the presence of children within the community of faith. We affirm the love of God made known in this child and the sacredness of the covenant shared between this child and his parents in this congregation. The community and family of Trinity United Church of Christ commits to supporting Nicholas as he lives and grows in this walk with Jesus Christ. So God's glorious acts of salvation have been made known through us through water, from the moving of the Spirit upon the waters of creation, to the great flood and rebirth of humanity, to the parting of the Red Sea and the meeting of the Samaritan woman at the well, in Jesus Christ, baptized by John in the Jordan River and anointed by the Holy Spirit. These are all things related to water. And together we commit to nurturing one another in our walk with Christ, in our faith, in new life through baptism, and we include the care of Nicholas in our covenant. So now's the quiz part. He doesn't know the answers yet. He will. Parents and sponsors, do you desire to have Nicholas baptized into this Christian community? If so, please respond, we do. Will you lead Nicholas by example in the teachings of Jesus, the importance of the church community, and to do justice, love mercy, and walk humbly with God? If so, respond, we will. Will you walk with your child, at times leading and at times side by side, and at times by following as Nicholas discovers the wonder of God's love made manifest here today? If so, please respond, we will. Family and gathered, do you who witness and celebrate this sacrament promise your love and support and care as Nicholas lives and grows in this Christian community? Please respond, we will. Now, all of us, together, we will surround Ashley, Eric, Madison, and Nicholas in a community of love and forgiveness that they may grow in their faith of Jesus Christ, in their trust of God, and their service to others through the blessing and guidance of the Holy Spirit. So, gracious God, pour out your Holy Spirit and bless this gift of water, that it may in turn bless Nicholas and clothe him in new life and love throughout his life. We ask your blessings on all who are gathered here today, that they are one with Christ. Please join with me. Praise to you, eternal God, the one who was and is and shall always be, world without end, through your Son, Jesus Christ, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns forever. Amen. It's falling. Hey, Nicholas. How you doing? All right. Well, Nicholas, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. May God's great mercy bless you and give you understanding of love's great presence and wisdom and grace in your life. May God nourish you. He's like, you're really looking at me. I get a turn. May God nourish you with the riches of eternal faith and make you persevere in all good works. May God keep your eyes and steps from wandering and direct you in the paths of love and grace. Let the Holy Spirit work within you that being born through water and spirit, you may be a faithful disciple of Jesus Christ. Through baptism, you are born into God's new creation and welcomed into the body of Christ. With joint thanksgiving, we ask God's blessing upon you now and always. Members of this household of God, friends and family, Nicholas has been commended to your love and care. Do all in your power to increase Nicholas's faith, hope, and perfect him in love. Folks, this is Nicholas. Say hi. Hi. You say hi to everybody? Say hi. Wow, he's so chill. A blessing. We give thanks for all that God has already given you, Nicholas, and we welcome you in Christian love. As your family and friends, together with you, in the body of Christ, in the presence of God, we renew our covenant to faithfully participate in the ministries of the church by our prayers, our presence, our gifts, our service, and our witness that in everything God may be glorified through Jesus Christ. Amen. You did awesome. It's already dry, but. So again, let's welcome Nicholas. Yay! Yay! All right. Thank you so much. Want to go with Dad, or you want to stay with me? Yeah. Oh, we also have a gift from our Christian nurture. Awesome.
Who's got the clicker?
We're going right into the youth message. All right. Well, I ask all of our youthful at heart to come forward. How's it going? Hey, look, they brought snacks for us. Look at that. Anybody bring a can opener? Yeah, I heard about that, yes. Well, good morning. Happy Sunday. Yay! So how'd you get here today? Did you walk? Or did you come in a car or a truck? Hello. Well, you got here somehow, right? Yeah, you probably walked. Yeah. This time you drove? Ooh. Well, you know, there's these weird things that we have nowadays in cars. And they talk back to us. How many have a GPS? Global Positioning System. GPS. And I'll tell you what, when they first came out, they were horrible. I mean, it was like, okay, and I said some really nice things about my wife, Brenda, earlier today. But she's also one that always tells me where I'm missing a turn or I didn't go the right way, like I wasn't driving the right direction. So they make these gadgets called GPS, and you plug them into your car. And did you ever notice that most GPSs are what voice? A woman, like a mom or a wife or your sister. And it's kind of interesting because it makes sense. We obey that because we know they're right. In fact, I had one GPS that I won a couple points, and around this time of the year, I changed the voice to Dracula. And it literally told jokes while you were driving. Oh, there's a bump in your trunk. Wonder what it is. So it would do these weird things. Well, I also look at GPS as also being God positioning system. In other words, there's these things that we do that when we know we're going in the wrong direction, we hear this voice or we hear the voice of the Holy Spirit, God saying, maybe that's not the route you want to go. Go in a different direction. Well, this morning we started off with a song called, In God There Is No East, West, North, or South. I would say that God is in all of those, every direction. And what we know about where we go is that once we get there, that's not the end of the road. We keep moving on. So this GPS that we have that taps us on the shoulder and says, maybe you should help somebody do that. Maybe open the door for someone. Maybe help more at home or do those things that your mom says you need to do without grumbling. And that's when we know that we're going in the right direction. Because when you do something good, doesn't it feel good? It literally does. I mean, it's kind of goofy. It's like when you do something good, you feel good. Well, I know you all can do that. In fact, I know you do it every day. the way you smile, the way that you greet people, the way that you are excited about what you have to do. These are all good things. So let us pray together. Dear Jesus, you give us the right path. And all we have to do is put our foot forward, raise up our eyes, and know that you will lead us in what is good and what is love. For this we thank you. Amen. All right. So, each get a compass. Pick one out. That way you always know kind of a direction. Do you know how a compass works? Do you all know how a compass works? It's a magnet. There's exactly. There you go. What color you want? There you go. You're welcome. All right.
Say thank you, Henry.
You're welcome.
Let's go back to Do
you want one?
I would like to invite the celebration singers up to the altar to sing The Lord is My Shepherd, and it's a musical version of Psalm 23.
Thank you.
Thank you. So yes, we are following, I guess, the Bible by the numbers. And today is number 4. I feel like one of those Sesame Street things, you know. What's the number of the day? It's 4. Well, 4 is unity. That's one of the meanings of 4. And when you look at the things, again, I mentioned it when I opened up worship this morning, 4 has a lot of images in our lives, has a lot of, I guess, things that we can pull from. So again, I mentioned a chair. Now, we know that there's 3-legged stools. In fact, I've been told, and I know this for a fact, because my kitchen chairs, I don't know if you have to keep adjusting them all the time, but like all of a sudden, it's like they'll rock. It's like why? But a 3-legged stool doesn't do that. But 4 does. So 4 says there's something about the connection of all the parts and pieces have to be in unity. They have to be like. So 4. I'll give you a couple things about 4 in the Bible, as I've been doing. What's the 4th commandment? Anybody? Wow. Y'all got to come to confirmation class this coming Wednesday, please. It's remember the Sabbath. Sorry. But think of it this way. In that great, I guess, alignment of the commandments, they were aligned to something that came way earlier, which was the creation of the world. Guess what happened on the 4th day? Wow. Okay, Sunday school too, yes. That's when God actually put all of creation, the world, the universe, the stars, he got it all done. God finished that part. We don't come for a couple of days, but creation happened in totality, if you want to call it, on the 4th day. All right. Boy, I should get some more quiz words here. Here we go. The Apostle Paul was a man familiar with 4 major first century cultures. Again, this is drawing in the number 4, the Apostle Paul. He was a Roman citizen. He was a Jew who spoke Greek and Hebrew, and he was a Christian. 4. The Garden of Eden had a river that parted into the headwaters of 4 other rivers. These rivers were the Pisan, the Gihon, Hiddekel, and the Euphrates. 4 out of creation. After Jesus was nailed and hung on a cross, Roman soldiers divided his clothes into 4 parts. The 4 witnesses of God on earth are miracles. See, I should probably quiz this too. All right. The witness of God on earth are miracles, wonders, signs, and the gifts of the Holy Spirit from Hebrews 2, 4. Lazarus had been dead in his tomb for 4 days before Jesus came to Bethany to resurrect him from the dead. The question is, why did Jesus wait so long? Because we know, obviously, other stories of 3. Why 4? I found this kind of interesting. It's because he waited so that there was no doubt, especially among his harshest critics, that Lazarus was undeniably dead. He did this to maximize the glory of bringing him back. Revelation, the 4 horsemen of the apocalypse, symbolize global calamities to come upon the earth in the near future. And then I think the last, the four main types of sacrifices made to God in the Jewish Bible were burnt sacrifice, sin sacrifice, trespass, and peace offerings. Four. Enough of that. Boy, it's all my notes. Man, okay. But the one of the things that was going through my mind with this unity thing was going back to what that four represents in my own life. In other words, there's things that we see all the time that we're going, why? Why does it look so familiar? And I point to what's behind me, the cross. We've heard it told before that the cross is literally four points. Okay? So it's from earth or us to God, the connection. That is the vertical. It's the vertical. It's us to God, connection. The cross then also goes across horizontally, two more points. That's us. That's us together. That's us in the world. That is us loving each other. All four have to happen. I'm going to say that again. All four have to happen. What the heck is going on in the world right now? We're not doing this really good. In fact, we're doing this like this. Or we're doing it like this. Or like this. Unity only happens when all four things are happening. We cannot ask God to fix what is happening in the world if we aren't willing to do it ourselves. We can say we're connected to God, but if we don't actually do it, it's not going to happen. God created us to be love, first and foremost. And when we forget to do that, when we forget to stretch our arms to our neighbors and listen and talk and hear and do those things that love does, then that is when we create the connection. When we show them, when we show ourselves that we can. It's so interesting to hear how we can say and prove why we need to do the things that are not love. In fact, we will take more time to make excuses for why we can't rather than why we can. I watch the news a lot, and I probably shouldn't. But again, I should. But you know what? Most of the stuff that we see in our media is literally our confusion and our excuses for why we can't. They'll spend more type in an article trying to convince you of why this should not work, why peace cannot work. It always amazes me that the majority of all the wars and conflicts that we have in the world are based on what? Religion. That's why I hate that word. Because to me, it's a negative. It says that we will put in front of us our religion and use it as a shield to say that we won't. And I would rather pull it apart and say, you know what? This is me. When Jesus hung on the cross, when he was put to death for us, it wasn't because we had a plan. It's because we were scared. We were so scared of what love was doing that we couldn't take it. And we said, get it out of here. Kill it. And what does Jesus do on the cross? He forgives us. He says, Dear Father, they don't know what they're doing. But forgive them. They'll get it. They'll get it someday. They'll get it some way. They'll get it however it comes to them. So we literally have four. We've got God. We've got Jesus Christ. We have the Holy Spirit that connects us all, but the fourth part is what? Us. Unity in everything that we do so that we can connect from God to each other to be there for all. Yes, we pray for those that are at war. We pray for the pulling back of the reason. We can't go over there and take the bullets for them. But we could start right here, right now, in acknowledging that we do have differences, that we do have things that we sometimes just don't agree with. But we can also learn to acknowledge and say, that's you. I'm not going to change you. Jesus didn't necessarily come to this world to change us. What Jesus came to this world was to give us the reason for change and how you do it. The only way you change is right here. And you got all the tools. Baptism wakes us up. Baptism brings us to the water of the living God. It brings us together in a way that says we are all of water. But now that you got it in you, now it's up to you. This is not big enough to take a bath. But it's big enough to come into you. So in unity, in four, come together. Come together. Let us pray. Dear glorious God, we know that the world challenges us. We know this by the calls and the cries of our brothers and sisters, our siblings across the world. We cannot know their pain in the way that they do, just as they don't know ours. And sometimes the pain comes because we feel helpless, that we can't do it. We can't fix it. We can't make it better. But then you tap us on that shoulder, be it the right or the left, and you say, yes, you can, my child. You say, yes, you can. You can be there for someone. And if you try to pick it, you may fail, because then it's about you. God, give us the opportunities and let us be open to what we are and who we are and whose we are, that we know that in everything that you've given us the ability to love and live and be there for each other. And for this, we are grateful. And we praise your name. Amen. Amen. This morning, yes, we As a church, we do not necessarily pass the plate anymore, and that was kind of a, I guess, pandemic thing. I do invite anybody that feels the, I guess, the want, the spirit to be a part of what we do here at Trinity, but not just what we do here as a church, but what we do as the church beyond the walls of Trinity. Just like we see, we're starting to gather food for the harvest to give it away. We don't know who's going to get it, but I'll tell you what, it's going to go to somebody good. And we don't ask for anything back. The same happens when we contribute to whatever it is in our lives that is either church or community or those things that we give to. My house is two blocks from the Humane Society in Sheboygan. And I can't tell you how fun it is on certain mornings to see the dog parade. It's like there's like 40 dogs walking by. And of course, we are dog sitting Buddy, my daughter Sierra's dog. And he has to make sure that he lets us know every time a dog goes by the windows. And he's not just a little barker, he's a big barker. But to him, he's probably saying, hey, how you guys doing? We have the ability to do the same thing in the church. We have the ability to look out the windows and we can say, hey, we see you're out there. Somebody open the door so I can get out. Well, our offerings do that. It literally takes our input and it puts it out there. So I hope that you give freely of who you are and why, so that the world may know something is good. So with that, let us join together in our invitation to the offering. All we have comes from you, O Lord. So we give our offerings and tithes with generous hearts in thanksgiving for all you do for us. May these gifts given today offer hope in proclaiming and sharing the good news of Jesus Christ, our Savior, with all the world. Please rise as you're able to, and please join me in singing the doxology.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Now please join with me in our prayer of dedication. Take our offerings and tithes, O God. Bless them that they may be used to share your love and blessing in our community and the world. May these offerings provide for the least of these needs and the proclamation of your word to those seeking hope. Amen. You may be seated. So yes, this morning we pray for all of our siblings, all those affected by war. And it's funny because it's almost like the new thing on the block. But we still know there's suffering and pain in Ukraine with the battles that they're having. And at the same time, now you've got another part of the world that is crying out the same way. Again, we can't be there at the table to fix it, but what we can do is we can be stronger in our commitment to faith and love that says we'll do what we can not to have that happen, and at the same time help through prayer, through support. It's interesting, my grandsons, and again, they don't watch news like I do. And I had the news on, and they saw some of the footage that was coming from the conflict. They're like, Grandpa, is that real? I said, yeah, it's real. So it's got to be real here. And it's got to be real to our God. I'm sure God is crying. Let's get past this. Let's get past it. But we have to live with it. This morning we have prayers for the Rohrig family. I did get to visit with them last week, and it was a good visit. Wonderful people. It's not a prayer. How did this get in here? Remind everyone of social time downstairs after worship. Special dessert in celebration of Nicholas. I pray it's good. And I pray that you all are there. That's too funny. Prayers for the snowy owl. Another one of those dear, I guess, inhabitants, co-inhabitants of this world. Climate change has caused habitat loss and, of course, human disturbance. So in our prayers, we pray for the creatures of the earth. Guess what? We're called creatures, too. At this time, I invite my confirmation friends to lead us in a thing that I found. It's called Prayers for the People. And you can follow along. Good morning. They're going to speak really loudly.
Gracious God, we thank you for all that you provide and the blessings we receive daily from you. We know that at times we feel hopeless amid so much uncertainty in our world, but we trust you. O God, to bring us peace and to give us comfort when we are overwhelmed with anxiety, please help us be calm in the chaos around us and give us the strength to overcome.
Let the people say amen. Amen.
Gracious God, we bring all your concerns, doubts, and insecurities with the confidence that you are walking with us and guiding us with your Holy Spirit. Mold us into the vessels you want us to be, full of hope and joy.
Let the people say amen. Amen.
Gracious God, we lift prayers for the homeless, the hungry, the lonely, the rejected, those left behind, and all suffering injustice in our community and the world. Hear their cries for healing, wholeness, and acceptance, O loving God.
Let the people say amen. Amen.
Gracious God, we ask that your Holy Spirit accompany and protect our black and brown siblings and LGBTQ communities dealing with violence and hatred. We pray for the continued strength and courage for all being persecuted by society. Let us not be afraid to stand boldly to speak against all hate and violence. God, you call us beloved even when we stand in the face of violence and fear. Please help us continue to be agents for transformation and equity.
Let the people say amen. Amen.
Gracious God, help us live according to your world's mandates that call us to love one another as you love us. Help to show mercy and offer compassion and forgiveness to all in our care. Help us acknowledge when we have not been good stewards or loving to our neighbor or the stranger.
Let the people say amen.
Gracious God, we pray that our hearts will be open to the change that needs to happen here on earth, so your kingdom will be a reality and all your creation will sing your praises. Please help us to see each other's as gifts from you. Let us enthusiastically embrace your love and share the good news with those who need to hear and receive your amazing grace. Amen.
Let the people say amen. Amen. Very good. Thank you. And coming from your voices, that means so much. I thank you. We can applaud a great prayer. And now we have a prayer to say together. It's that daily prayer that we find that Jesus gave us to remind us of what it is, who we are, whose we are, and what we are to do. So please join with me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our wrongs, as we forgive those who wrong us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Everybody say, good morning, Lana. Good morning.
It's still too high. Good morning.
Good morning.
Hello. My name is Lana Mash. I'm a member of the Church Council and on the Mission Committee, and I'd like to welcome you all to Trinity United Church of Christ, members, visitors, and online people. For the first thing, the Mission Committee, as Pastor pointed out, we're collecting Thanksgiving food items for the Waukesha Food Pantry. The last day for the collection is November 12th. After service, members of the Mission Committee will be in the gathering space handing out the slips of papers for the needed items for anybody who's willing to donate. You're supposed to bring your items up and put them in the front of the church before service. And then these food items will be used to help fill the food pantry Thanksgiving baskets that they will distribute. There also is our clothing drive going on until the end of October. The items are being taken to the St. Vincent de Paul to help out with people who need things. Let me get my notes. After church, they mentioned that there is things down in the dining room. Come join for fellowship and welcome Nicholas to our church. And any other announcements? In the back.
Thank you. I would like 6 to 8 more so we can have a good turnout. We had about 75 kids last year. So if we could get some more trunks, if you need help with ideas, it doesn't have to be a huge thing. I like doing a huge thing, but it can just be like a ghost or a pumpkin, something simple. You don't even have to dress up. You need to hand out candy. If you need any help at all, let me know and I'll help you out. The second thing is if you've noticed, I've been the clicker and I was a reader today. We could use some more help with the usher teams. It's pretty easy. Just have to be awake to use a clicker.
that's a challenge.
Reading isn't so bad. So if you are here on a Sunday and you would like to help, let the usher teams know. And it's just like once a month. It's pretty easy peasy. So let us know if you want to help.
Anyone else? Oh, in the back.
Hi, Cup of Life, and any of the ladies who want to can come with us on November 5th. We're going to the Sunset Playhouse here in town on Sunday at 2 o'clock matinee to see Blythe Spirit. I have collected some of the money. I would like to collect the rest of it by midweek so that I can go to the box office and order the tickets. We're going to meet here in carpool unless somebody wants to drive there directly, and then we'll probably go to dinner afterwards. So anybody who is interested and hasn't seen me and hasn't paid, please let me know. Thank you. Or Lynn Milkey.
Anyone else?
I do have a quick announcement. For those that are here that are on our memorial committee, we're going to have a short 5-minute meeting right after church, right by the piano. And no, I'm not going to recruit you to be part of the choir.
Okay, I guess that's it. Well, have a good week, everyone.
Please stand if you can and join in our closing hymn, Two Fishermen.
Two fishermen who lived along the Sea of Galilee stood by the shore to cast their nets into an ageless sea. Now Jesus watched from them afar and called them each by name. It changed their lives, these simple men, they'd never be the same. As he walked along the shore to James and John he'd find, and these two sons of Zebedee would leave their boats behind. Their work and all they held so dear, they left beside their nets. Their names they heard as Jesus called, they came without regret. Simon, Peter, Andrew, James, and John, beloved one, you heard the Christ whose name is meek, good news of God's own Son. So Hosanna, Mary Magdalene, who traveled with your Lord, you ministered to him with joy, for he is God adored. One and all who follow Jesus' way, come leave behind what keeps you bound to trappings of our day, and listen as he calls your name to come and follow near, for still he speaks in varied ways to those who know will hear. Leave all things you have and come and follow.
In Christ, there is no east or west, there is no south or north. What that means is there's no limit. No matter what direction you go, you will find you're needed. You will find that love is needed, that your presence, your abilities, your gifts are needed. Yes. Limitless unity. I want you to realize that what you do makes a difference. Even the smallest of things, if they're done in love, create more and more and more. So that is our call. It's to be that in the world, to be in the world and proving that God is alive, that God is love, that God is everywhere for everyone. May God take you into the next moment, loving, knowing that you're loved, and knowing that there's nothing that you can do that will take that away. So please, go in hope, joy, peace, love. Let the people say amen.
Amen.